First transplant, like what was the material? Metals.
Metals?
Yes.
That I have talked about the titanium and cobalt.
So why like these metals alone? Why not any steel or anything?
Like metals actually have great tensile strength. Actually, they are not easily broken. They have a corrosion resistance as well if we pour some material over here. And as compared to the polymers, they have less ductility. So that's where we're using. If I may be wrong,
they have less ductility.
They are not ductile.
Metals are not ductile.
Not more than like polymers.
Okay. Right. Okay. Okay, other questions? I would suggest that you talked about three classes of implants. One was metal-based, one was polymer-based, and one was ceramic-based. So in your paper, maybe you can make a table and make a comparison and show us the advantages, the pros and cons of each kind of implant, okay? I can make a comparison, that would be interesting. Okay, next question please.
Can we use anther metal in
can we use?
Like, except the titanium and cobalt, you are saying?
Yes.
Yes, we can. I have read that we can use stainless steel as well. But actually, it has iron in it, so there are more chances of getting corrosion than the titanium and cobalt. Like, titanium has greater like corrosion resistances compared to stainless steel.
Okay, one point that should be kept in mind in this case, because this is a biomedical application, in this case biocompatibility is very important. So when choosing the material, it has to be biocompatible.
Yes.
Because you did mention it, but you can go into more detail about biocompatibility.
Yeah, biocompatibility.
Because the choice of material depends on the kind of material that the human body accepts. So the human body does not accept just any kind of material. So we have to look at the mechanical properties and the corrosion and other factors that you're talking about, the ductility, machinability, the manufacturing and so on. But the biocompatibility and biotoxicity are two very important points in your application. Okay?
Yes.
So that's one of the major reasons or points behind the selection of materials.
Yes.
Because if your body is not acceptable, you can use it. So every material cannot be entered into the human body.
They can be actioned.
And of course, yes.
Yes.
It can be dangerous for your body, right? Okay. Next question please. Karma? अपना काम अच्छा करते हैं फिर दूसरों का काम सुनते हैं तो
मैं सुनना है मैंने
बताओ तो क्या सुनिए आप तो स्ट्रेस कर रही हैं यू आर रिलैक्स फील
कर
ओके एनीवे दैट वाज गुड रामी थैंक यू वेरी मच माय सजेशंस फॉर फर्दर इंप्रूवमेंट इन योर पेपर बिफोर द फाइनल सबमिशन हैव यू लुक्ड एट द बुक दैट आई वाज डिस्कसिंग
यस मैम
यस ओके सो हैव यू लुक्ड एट द चैप्टर्स दैट आर रेलेवेंट टू यू
Yes, mechanical properties.
Mechanical properties have been described in detail in the book.
Yes.
Like I was explaining to Fatima, I don't know if you were sitting at that time or not.
Yes.
From the book, you can get the concepts, the physics, the laws, the formulas, the tables, so on. But the exact values for your particular kind of material will come from your own reference material. Because the book does not discuss every material. It discusses the main concepts, right? So for you, the chapters relevant mechanical properties are important. Go through them again.
Alloys.
And describe in detail the mechanical properties. They are very relevant for your topic. And alloys, the chapter on alloys is very important for you. You can choose a material that is relevant to you. And also the chapter on ceramics is important for you. Right. Also, I think composite materials you should look at that. I'm sure some of these materials would be composites as well.
In implant tissues? Like
yeah, in implants you can check the composite materials as well.
I'm looking.
Right? And I don't remember if we have a chapter on biocompatibility or biomaterials or something like that.
No,
but then you can find this information for another reference.
Actually, individual chapters may be biocompatibility.
Okay, check this out. Okay? Yes. And also try to illustrate with the help of the values, for example, for mechanical properties, what's the range of values we need, like you said. That this material has a good tensile strength. So what is the requirement for a knee joint? What's the range of the tensile strength that we need in that case?
it's like, no man, like you replace a human heart with a pig's heart, so can't you replace
something
like
that?
Maybe it's their insensation, maybe it's their